Hello everyone and welcome to today's episode of The Beat. Dear viewers, as you all know, The Beat is a musical program which brings you all everything that's related to music, not only Egyptian songs or not only Egyptian musicians, but we touch and reach international musicians that come to Egypt and that make special events here in Egypt. The Beat is a very specialized musical program which comes to you from different places, different musical places here in Cairo. And today, dear viewers, we are in a different place. We go to Opera House, we go to Saeed al-Sawi, we go to every single place here in Egypt that holds a musical event. We also go to, of course, Zamalek Theater. We go everywhere, and today we have a very special episode that I'd love, that entertains you, especially in this very difficult days, dear viewers, when we are, of course, witnessing a pandemic, COVID-19, where you need to be entertained, and we're here because it's our job to make you happy, dear viewers. Stay home, stay strong, and we'll always do our job to make you entertained. The viewers, I'm your host for today's episode, and I'm Rana Al Qasas. Stay tuned and don't go away.
Hisham Gabr is a resident conductor at the Cairo Opera House and director of the Biblioteca Alexandrina Arts Center, a dynamic cultural institution and part of the renowned Library of Alexandria, Egypt. Gabr studied conducting in Egypt, France and the United States with several renowned conductors, Christophe Mueller, Dominique Huit, Jean-Jacques Warner, Chris Kim and Ahmed El-Saidi. He was granted the Fulbright Senior Grant to continue his conducting development in the United States of America, where he completed the Advanced Conducting Techniques studies at the Cornell University, New York. Besides his regular commitments as a conductor at the Cairo Opera House, Gabr has been invited to conduct many international orchestras and is now a returning guest conductor in many of them. As such, Gabr cooperates as a conductor and composer with a number of international orchestras and renowned artistic institutions, among them Macedonian Philharmonic Orchestra, Wroclaw Philharmonic Orchestra in Poland, Kyiv Camerata, National Symphony Orchestra of Mexico, Sofia Philharmonic Bulgaria, Göttingen Symphony Orchestra, Astana Philharmonic Orchestra, Lebanese Philharmonic Orchestra, and more. In Egypt, Gabr conducts on a regular basis major national orchestras during symphonic and opera performances. The Cairo Symphony Orchestra, Cairo Opera Orchestra, besides his duties as the resident conductor and artistic director of the Biblioteca Alexandrina Chamber Orchestra. Since early 1990s, Gabr is also composing music to numerous feature movies, documentaries, musicals, and theater plays produced in Egypt and abroad. His compositions were performed by the Cairo Symphony Orchestra and were acclaimed by both audience and critics. Among his recent compositions is Ibn Battuta, The Prince of Travelers, the first big production performed on stage of the new National Theatre of Bahrain, celebrating Manama being chosen as the Arab capital of tourism when it was performed later in Muscat Royal Opera House and Milano Expo in 2015. Gabr also composed music to Proxa, the first Egyptian musical, which was successfully performed at the Cairo Opera House Main Hall and at the Royal Opera House Muscat. Gabr receives frequent commissions to compose music for prestigious Egyptian and international institutions and orchestras. Over the recent years, he has been commissioned by the Egyptian Ministry of Culture, Egyptian Ministry of Information, along state and private institutions in Bahrain, Oman, and Lebanon.
Actually, I'm quite pleased and I feel blessed with all this success. This concert had a very long story. It started in 2015 when me and Marianne Khoury, she's in charge in Mesr International Films, which is the company that Yusuf Shaheen has founded. We were thinking of a way to make a musical tribute to Yusuf Shaheen. At this time, I was in charge of the arts in the Biblioteca Alexandrina, And we first talked about it when I was there. And then in 2018, Ilguna Film Festival was interested to produce such a show. So the idea was, as you have seen, that we are going to perform in sync with the moving pictures from the movies of Yusuf Shaheen. And it was first performed in the Ilguna Festival, and it had a big success. And today I'm thankful that the Cairo Opera House has decided to re-perform this performance in tribute to the great Yusuf Shaheen. And here we are. I wouldn't say the Egyptian orchestras and the other orchestras. I would say that each and every orchestra is different. The response is different. The strength and weakness points are different. Everything is different. It's an organism. It's a living organism. It's like a human body. The orchestra there are no two people with the same face. Every orchestra is different. I would say that the audience in Egypt, they're growing. We had some time that the audience were not as interested as we hope in attending classical, symphonic, operatic, ballet music, etc. But it's growing, and I think the audience now are more interested. And the last 10 years are getting better and better. I would say that I'm very privileged. I did 4 or 5 projects for other composers. I find that this is a great way to learn about music, learn really in depth. You know the deepest elements and details of how a big composer thinks. So it's a good thing. Also, because I am reorchestrating the whole music, I took only the melodies and then I made a rearrangement and orchestration. So it is always very good challenge to work as a composer on the music of other composers, because it's a great input, and you get to process how great minds think in depth, and so I find myself very privileged to do so. I'm going on. I'm keeping trying to develop and trying to learn more and trying to work more and compose more. Well, it's a lifetime process. Once you stop learning, you will stop composing. I have a thousand dreams, and I'm sure that not enough lifetime to do them all. But I'm trying to I'm trying to make as much as possible of my dreams.
Well, dear viewers, this is all for today's episode of The Beat. Hope you've enjoyed being with us as much as we have. Until we meet again in another episode of The Beat, which comes to you twice a week, dear viewers. From all the team here, myself, your host for today's episode, Rana Al-Qasas, and of course our directors, Rami Abdelaziz and Dalia Muhib. Dear viewers, before I leave, I'd like to remind you to stay strong, stay safe, and stay home because of the coronavirus pandemic, which is everywhere nowadays. Please stay home and please please take care of yourselves, and we are here to entertain you and bring you everything that's happening all over the country, especially when it comes to music. And until we meet again, dear viewers, it's goodbye.